is on my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom. All I wanna do is on my zoom.
Everybody check your babies for AIDS.
Yeah.
Check baby one, check baby two, check baby three, check baby four, check them all for lice, and check them all for AIDS.
The two most important checks you can
that
do
song
on
is
a baby.
Just, he's just concerned about babies?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's telling you to check your babies.
Check baby one.
Check baby two.
Check baby three.
He works
he
at
the hospital.
He has like three or four kids there.
The orderly at the hospital.
Mm. Check your baby for AIDS if you have a baby. This is Baby AIDS Awareness Month, September.
Yeah.
They have home tests for that?
You can get a home test, but it has to be administered by a nurse or someone professional.
Get a home test if you're a nurse.
You have to hire someone to come to your house.
They got
to
put a stick in your baby's butt.
Really?
Uh-huh.
The AIDS stick.
Yeah, it's a stick that tells if your baby has AIDS.
So it's a special stick?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Or does the stick just administer the special thing?
It's a
medical stick. It's like a litmus test.
Oh, yeah. So it has like a special thing.
It's coated in something.
Okay, and then it's also sterile. It comes in a little Ziploc,
no,
probably.
Loose in a box. Yeah, you could just grab them.
The box is way larger than the stick. It just kind of jangles around in there.
Really?
Yeah. Well, they have them like on the counter. You can just stick your hand in there and grab like four.
You just grab whatever you want.
Sticks, yeah.
What if you grab one?
Right next to the used stick pile.
Yeah, I don't know why they have the used. I don't know why you have to bring the used sticks back and put them in the used box next to the
box. They're not clearly marked either.
No, it just says sticks, baby sticks.
You just got to know the one on the right is the clean ones.
Yeah, and there's different colors, but they don't say what the colors mean.
It's a lot of false people. Yeah, it's really kind of a mess.
False positives.
False positives, because people get like an AIDS baby. They'll grab a used stick from an AIDS baby out of the used box and put it in their baby's butt, and then they're like, oh no, my baby's got AIDS.
Yeah.
But they probably give their baby AIDS too.
That's also a thing. If the AIDS positive stick touches a new stick, and then even if it's a new stick.
Yeah. It's really weird because there was no such thing as baby AIDS until the stick test came out.
I know.
There was zero cases of baby AIDS until the baby AIDS stick test.
I know.
And now there's, you know.
There's a lot. Yeah. There's a lot of baby AIDS going around.
Yeah.
That's so check your baby. This is
baby
September.
check your baby.
Check all your babies for AIDS
month.
And lice.
Yeah.
And lice.
Yeah.
Use the other end of the stick.
Just rub it in your baby's hair.
Yeah.
Make sure it doesn't have lice.
Yeah.
Right near the eye. Rub it right.
September 11th is coming up. Oh.
Randy just tried to sit up straight and listen to what happened.
Randy's got a crickety spine.
Yeah.
I'm drinking soda, y'all. Summertime. Soda time.
It's not summertime anymore, idiot.
Happened,
Labor Day happened.
Is that what Labor Day means?
Yep, end of summer.
End of summer.
It's still hot.
Dump your soda down the drain.
Oh, man. All
right. How much you pay for that soda?
I don't know.
If it was summertime, would I be wearing this awesome sweater?
No. Oh, probably not. Hey, that's mine.
No, it's not. It's mine.
I left it here last time.
Oh, well, finders keepers, losers weepers is the way the saying goes.
Wait, you're meaning it, though?
Uh-huh.
I've heard that saying, but I never heard it meant.
Yeah.
So you're keeping it?
Yeah. Looks good on me.
That's funny. That hurts my feelings, though.
Oh, really?
It's also small on me and big on you. So that makes my feelings hurt, too.
Yeah. My feelings hurt.
Let's
too.
All switch around Randy's sweater and see how his feelings get hurt. With
I don't like things that go around me being able to be compared to things that you know how big they are. Because then that's the easiest way for you to know how fat I am.
So you're fat enough to fill in this sweater.
Yeah.
How loose does it feel on you, man?
I mean, it's not, you know,
it's not loose, really. It's very slimming on me because it's black and it draws two lines together. It's a cardigan, so it's nice V-shaped. Makes me look slim.
Does it make me look slim?
Makes you look
Frumpy.
I can tell where my fat wrists have stretched it out.
Yeah.
But that's because I have long arms, and those, where it's hitting your wrist, it's actually...
Oh, they come up to there.
They're like high water sleeves.
Yeah. I have that problem, too.
Yeah.
I have long arms.
Long-ass arms.
Oh, I know what I was going to say.
What?
Fuck you, Randy!
What?
What?
It's a hoax, bro. It's a practical joke.
Yeah, you got pranked.
You just got pranked.
So you're not keeping it?
No.
No, he's keeping it.
I'm keeping it.
That's part of the prank.
No, I pranked you by saying F you.
I thought I'm so confused. I thought the fuck you was like, all right, prank's over, fuck you.
No, the actual fuck you was the prank. That was the prank.
Yeah, you should have seen your face. You had a totally I just got fuck you'd face.
Well, part of it was because it was so loud it hurt my ears.
Yeah.
So I actually physically moved my body.
Ugh.
You tried to get away from the mic, but the earphones were still on.
Yeah.
You like moved away as if that was...
Oh, man.
Why do we even need earphones?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Should we do...
Well, I guess if we're going to play the trumpet noise.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we wouldn't be able to hear the trumpet noise.
You know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? It's a new Bone Zone.
It's a new Bone. I'm going to say it like the way everybody on American Idol sings.
Okay.
You have stepped into the bone zone. Yeah.
That was really good.
See, yeah. I can't tell if I can sing good or bad, but I think that sounds pretty good.
No, that was
if
really,
you want my honest opinion.
That was really good.
And sitting across from me to my left, your right is Dr. Davey. And to my right and your left is Randy Licky.
You're
pretty good.
Really good the whole time.
Yeah,
100% of the time. You're really good.
Have you ever considered going into like singing, songwriting?
No.
Never considered music.
I should do a competition.
Yeah.
Yeah. The journey is just beginning for you.
Really?
I think so.
Well, the covering of Journey songs has just begun for you.
Yeah.
Really think that sounds good?
You have the sound, I like your look.
Really?
Yeah. And I think you're like America's gonna fall in love with you.
Really?
Yeah.
I like what you did because you took a familiar thing, you made it your own, and you flipped it around, and when it came out of you, I didn't feel like you were doing karaoke. I felt like you were doing poetry and you were singing something from the heart.
Really?
And I also like your look. I like the loose cardigan that you're wearing. Uh-huh. I think you should just a little bit more work with some of the people that we have here in Hollywood, and you're going to be going places. So I'd like to keep you.
I've heard the Bone Zone introduced lots of times.
Uh-huh.
Never like that.
Really?
Never. First time I've ever heard anything like that.
And to think about like all the things that you've gone through to be here today.
I know.
You know, your story.
I know.
And the people you're representing.
I know. My baby died of AIDS.
Yeah, you forgot to have him tested in September.
I gave my baby AIDS.
With the stick test.
Yeah. He died. Well, this performance is dedicated to my AIDS baby.
Your baby is smiling up in heaven.
He's up in heaven. That's where he is for sure.
Smiling down.
All babies go to heaven.
Yeah, all of them.
Yeah.
Well, you have to have him baptized because of your original sin thing.
I never got him baptized.
I mean, there's maybe Catholicism isn't the right one. Well, Nazarene? What religion?
Did your baby have gay sex?
No.
No, he just got tested for it.
That's the third judge.
The third judge.
He just doesn't do any judging.
The third judge that's just off in his own world.
Where do Jewish babies go then?
Jewish heaven, man.
Dog heaven.
Hell.
Yeah.
Okay.
That didn't mean anything by that. Jew listeners.
No offense, Jew listeners.
I meant to say you listeners.
Jew listener, yeah.
That's okay, man. We love you. We love all you Jews out there with your big Jewish schnauzes. And
you talking about their dogs? Schnauzers.
Schnauzers, I mean.
Yeah.
No, Jews wouldn't have a German dog, would they? Schnauzer, that's German.
There's German Jews.
They just beat the dog up every day.
Also, I forgot to introduce Red Man, which is why he keeps ruining all of our sketches. On the ones and twos and threes and fours and the ABCs and one, two, threes. Brian Redband.
Hi.
Woo!
No presents Davey, this week, by
Davey way. Johnston.
Yeah.
Brian Redband.
The T is pronounced, but not in the name. It's pronounced, but not in the spelling of my name. Johnston.
Yes.
Spelled without a T.
Randy's eating cookies, so I guess.
I'm just, what I'm trying to do is.
How many, do you have more cookies in there?
three for a dollar.
And you had
so
two before.
You've already eaten two cookies.
That could be true.
On the block walk over here. I
ate half of one on the way here.
Uh-huh.
And then two and a half since I got here.
Would you like a cookie, Brandon?
What kind of cookies you got?
I got like peanut butter chocolate.
Is it hot cookies. Though?
No.
Oh, no, I can't. I have to. Well, I'm not feeling very well either.
Here.
I ate like. No, that's got pot in it. I don't want to eat a pot cookie. Thank you, though. I have a tummy ache.
Oh, Brindy.
Yeah, I know.
Brindy.
My tummy, guys.
Brindy, bumble like, boo.
Oh, no, I don't feel good.
Do you need soup? Do you want us to go?
I had soup earlier.
Oh, wow. You want a little massage or something?
Yeah.
Rub your belly for you?
You want me? No.
No?
I don't want somebody to rub my belly.
Want to sit on our lap?
And we'll no. Take
you? You want to put some slippers on? I'll give
no.
you
a story. We'll read you a story. Turn the lights down. Read you a story.
You guys want to? I was watching Pawn Stars.
Yeah. You want TV?
Yesterday. You want TV?
Yeah, you guys want to watch TV?
Yeah.
I love TV.
Yeah, me too.
Relax, watch TV, eat an ice cream sandwich.
Yesterday I laid around and watched TV a lot.
Yeah. Really?
I was really tired from traveling and stuff.
Yeah.
And watched a lot of Pawn Stars. There's a lot of shit shows. There really are.
I was really
there's
tired.
There's so much shit.
From watching the Travel Channel.
Oh, because you felt like you traveled everywhere?
Yeah. I was like, fuck, man, I just got back from India, and now this. Looking at Kodiak bears and the fucking tundra.
I was looking at Cadillac bears.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, the gay guys, mm-hmm. The big hairy gay guys that ride around.
Yeah, yep, it's the big hairy gay guys at that cowboy bar that you go to.
Yep. They're really good at the Bronco, the Bucky Bronco.
There's. Yeah. Have you seen that Honey Boo Boo show?
I've not seen it.
I'm addicted to it.
She has her own show. Right?
Horrible. Yeah.
Is it horrible good?
Where's she
good?
From?
Is it good horrible? Do you like
no,
it?
No, it's terrible. It's awful. It's disgusting.
Did you see the forklift foot? The fork lift.
Yeah, there were bugs crawling around.
Yeah,
foot.
What the yeah. fuck is all those bugs?
What?
Dude, it's fucking disturbing. I watched like,
Honey Boo Boo's got bugs in her foot.
Yeah, that's, she like has a fucked up foot. She's disgusting. Like, I mean, it's literally like a garbage bag. Yeah, I don't. How do you know who this person is? Is she famous?
She was from a different show,
people are obsessed with her.
The online community like.
We're like, we like these disgusting pig people.
Well, she was like,
they like
we want to
child.
See more of
they
them.
Like the
she
child,
was
yeah.
being ridiculous, so someone posted like a 2-minute clip of her, and that got really popular online.
Yeah. And now they have a TV show.
Yeah.
Did you see the other show?
Jeez,
oh my
Randy.
God, dude.
Was yeah. that all three? All
yeah, those
three?
Disgusting. I hate disgusting people. The, like those yeah. disgusting people.
Yeah.
They're disgusting.
The
yeah.
yeah.
I don't like disgusting.
I like how Honey Boo Boo's become the new kind of buzz phrase for all hacky comedians to say, like all.
Oh, I don't know. I was, like I've been unaware. Like if I've heard Honey Boo Boo on stage, I just didn't make a connection. I just, yeah. I didn't know about this show until yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Have you heard the other show? The crazy two-headed girl show?
Mm. Those twins who are connected at the head?
Yeah. I've been watching them grow up.
I've seen them for a while. Yeah. I'm surprised they're still alive.
Yeah.
One's a country singer, one's a stand-up comedian,
those
right?
No, that's a different two-headed person, lady. These ones are younger.
Yeah, here, look, here's
the country western singer ones.
This is a show, huh?
These ones are the most convincing one.
Oh, Jesus Christ. So seriously?
We have to always stare and take pictures because we don't like when they take
pictures.
So it's
just
so
two heads, one body.
Yeah.
Who we are.
And they both date separate people, so the other person has to sit there and read a book while the other one's, like, making out with them.
They show this on the show?
Yeah. I haven't really watched too much of it.
Well, this is the older.
Is that their brother?
Yeah, this is like a documentary of it.
Their brother has one head, two bodies.
He has two dicks. Dude, I want to get blown by the fucking two-headed chick.
Oh, that'd be weird. I don't know.
What? No, I want to get blowed by them, bro.
You do? For real?
Yeah.
One sucking on each ball.
Ooh. No, just keep switching back.
One on the asshole. One
can they kiss? Are they like close enough to kiss?
Yeah, they get in a lot of crazy shit. Look at this.
So this is a TV show.
Look at this nonsense.
Yeah, this is what America
wants.
Wait,
how old are they?
This is when they turned 16. This was originally the documentary that older does the now, TV. Though. Yeah, they're like 18 now.
Okay, good.
They usually bargain with each other. Like, if you do this, I'll give you that, or we take turns.
Same
we
voice.
Take turns a lot. When they first started to drive, it was kind of scary.
That's their sister. She's got 18 tits.
And go too slow, and then go too fast, and then do slow. Hold on.
Their dad has three buttholes.
Look at that.
If I had a... If my brother was attached to me, I would...
So wait, the one controls the one arm?
Yeah.
And the other controls the other arm?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Leg, also. Oh, one leg.
What the fuck?
I want to know, do they both feel, like, if you finger them, do they both feel it, or...
That's, I mean, that's why you have to send all your questions and correspondences to the address shown at
God,
the
it's
show.
So weird looking, right?
Yeah. I mean, I feel sorry for them.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know, maybe they have a great life. That's crazy, I've never seen anything like that.
Could you imagine like one's just became like an alcoholic and one's like...
Well, that's what happened to the original Siamese twins.
Chang and Yang? Or
Chang and Yang. One of them was a fucking crazy alcoholic and drank himself to death. And then the other one died like a fucking day later.
As a result?
Yeah, it's something like that. But one of them was a wicked, crazy alcoholic. Hmm. And the other one was pissed off.
I would just eat a bunch of stuff that way... make my Siamese twin fart a bunch. Because they share a butthole.
Yeah. A butthole. A butthole.
They're beholden.
A butthole.
Do you want to see them in a bikini?
A
yes.
Wait.
Of course I do.
Wait, maybe this was... Oh, this was a trick. Never mind.
Oh, you got a virus. This podcast now has a virus.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa, what? You're showing what their like insides look like. Hold on, I'll show it.
Oh, it's just a drawing.
They have two hearts. One rib cage, two gallbladders, one pelvis, one large stomach.
Three kidneys.
Wait, did they? All the details, how many vaginas do they have? Do you want to see that?
Stomachs, etc.
Damn it.
Stomachs, etc.
If they.
One pelvis.
Oh, Jesus, whatever.
Who's this asshole? All right.
Oh, there they are.
So, yeah.
In a bikini.
Oh, fuck.
Wow.
Is that really that? I
found the driving part pretty interesting.
All right, I want to listen to this jerk off talking about him.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, if you think you got problems, man, you're not a two-headed teenage girl.
Oh, yeah. Teenage girls have problems to begin with.
I know. Imagine having two heads and 17 buttholes.
Two heads, one period.
Yeah, they get one period.
Yeah.
What if it's like the double period, though?
Oh, yeah.
Double period.
Or it's just one period, but it has...
But they have different cycles.
Yeah.
So they get periods twice a month.
Oh, man. No.
If you had three heads, you wouldn't have a period. You'd have an ellipses.
Oh, yeah, I get it.
You get it? You get that? Do you get that one, Randy?
Uh-huh.
Do you get it?
Okay. Randy doesn't get it.
No, I get it.
Three.
How to explain it, then?
Three.
So it's you have three heads.
Three heads. If these two-headed people have two periods, a three-headed person would have an ellipses.
Okay. Yeah, I get it.
Three.
Explain it. Explain why it's funny.
So if three heads.
Three periods.
Three periods.
Three periods.
What are the three periods next to each other? What is that?
Well,
an eclipse. Like you said, an eclipses.
Because
it's like a moon.
Randy doesn't get it.
No, I get it.
Think about your grammar, your basic grammar.
My grandma?
Think about your grandmom's period.
Think about your grandmom's period.
I don't think she has
her irregular three period.
Your grandmom's on her period right now.
Yeah. My grandma called me yesterday.
She caught you?
Called me. It's my birthday yesterday.
Oh
fuck.
Happy Randy. Birthday, dude.
Thanks, guys.
Oh, fuck, Randy.
What?
Oh, jeez, man.
Thanks, fuck, Randy.
Jeez, why?
Man. Why fuck Randy?
Fuck you, Randy.
Fuck happy you. Birthday, asshole. Randy. Fucker.
Thanks, guys.
Keeping it to yourself.
My grandma called me.
Secret birthday Randy.
Yes. My grandpa...
is this your birthday week?
No, I celebrated my birthday the 2 days before my birthday, so now I feel like it's over, even though it's closer than ever.
Yeah.
Well,
no, it's further away than ever.
Oh, yeah, it's a whole, can't get any closer.
Yeah.
Can't get any farther away.
Yeah.
That's what I meant.
You have to wait 364 days for your birthday to happen.
Oh, man.
What could happen? You could die, bro.
Yeah, I could die or I could become... I could grow another head.
Might have been your last.
You're not going to grow another head.
Become an ellipses.
No, you'd have to grow two more heads. You don't know the...
Yeah, but you don't understand.
A tumor
and you're
head?
Not, and you're not a woman either.
Grow
you'd
a tumor
have to be
head?
A three-headed woman with three periods would make it an ellipses.
Anyways...
Because you know what an ellipsis is, right?
Yeah, it's
It's when the sun blocks.
No, out. Randy.
Well, okay. If that's what you think it is, explain why that joke is funny. If that's what it is.
Okay, I'll tell you why. Okay. Because if you had three heads and one of them was trying to look at the one that's not in the one in the middle would block it, and it would be an ellipsis.
What's that have to do with her periods?
It has
though?
Nothing to do with her periods.
Because each head is a period, and they have three periods, and then when the
All right. Okay. So it works on two levels.
Yeah.
So the joke you've just proven is a brilliant joke.
So you could have a head eclipse.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. So why don't you check your grandmom?
Okay. Oh, shit.
What?
Oh, no. I think I took her. I don't know. I think I might have left my grandmom in the dryer.
Was
Did
it?
Did you?
Like, yeah, I might have.
Like, is it the cycle over?
It's on the proper cycle, though.
Is it still cycling or is it over? And it's just sitting there, your grandmom's sitting there?
Yeah, I think she's just sitting there.
You're sitting in the...
I
is
put
it,
her in there a while ago.
Is it your own dryer, or do you share it with the rest
it's
of your units?
Apartment, yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if someone needs to put their grandmom in it, they're going to have to take your grandma
put her
out
on top of it.
And put it...
So they'll just set her on top of the dryer. She'll be waiting for me when I get there.
But what if she's not done? She's going
to
sit there
have to
all
put her
cold
back in there,
and wet?
Yeah, I guess so. She wasn't really that wet when I put her in.
Really?
No. Yeah, I kind of just put her in to do it.
Just because it's like... proper.
It's the thing to do, man. Yeah. It's the end of summer, you know.
What if she wanders off though? Inside the dryer, she's just, you know, she's secure.
She's not gonna wander off.
She'll just wait for you.
She'll probably just sit there.
Yeah.
If she wanders off, nah. What's that?
One of those monkey noises.
It's a cat
clock.
Cat clock.
Is there a lot of pubic hair in your dryer lint thing?
That's basically all mine is. Like, I was asking people what color their dryer lint was.
Uh-huh.
And they're like, you know.
Grayish blue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they're like, what color is yours? And I'm like, red hair. Like, it's literally just hair.
Yeah.
Well, it depends on what I'm washing.
Do you have like, a huge thatch of pubes down there?
Yeah, I have, like, a loofah-sized pile of red hair pubes. Like, I wash my shower the other day with it.
With your pubes?
Mm-hmm.
You wash your shower?
So you, like, have to rub your pelvis all over your...
Yeah. But it's like, you know when you squeeze soap into a loofah and you just squeeze it a few times?
Oh, yeah.
You don't have to add soap again.
No.
Right.
You just get to keep using the same soap.
What happens when you gotta pee?
You get a lot of soapy pee?
Yeah, it just looks like a hose spraying through a fucking shrub.
Through like a, what were those things on Star Trek?
Tribble?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Star Trek, tribbles.
Yeah.
Randy doesn't know what we're talking about.
Yeah, Randy, could you explain why that's funny?
Yeah.
Yeah. Tribbles are, because of music, tribble clefs, and Star Trek... musical instrument, the Star Trek.
What sort of instrument is it? Like woodwind? What is it?
It's whatever instrument you choose, but it's the section on that show, Star Trek, with Ed McMahon.
Star Search?
If you don't get a joke, it's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
You don't have to like. Take us down this long winding road of lies.
I'm not lying. I get it.
Put your hands over yours for a second.
Yeah.
Ran.
Hey, Davey.
Yeah, Ran.
I'm going to prank Randy again.
Yeah.
Watch this.
Okay.
All right, Randy. You can take your hands off your ears.
What?
Take your hands off your ears.
Oh, hands off my...
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, I think...
I just remembered something.
Oh, yeah.
Randy.
What?
Fuck you!
What the hell?
Oh, my God. Totally pranked you, bro.
Oh, man.
What was the prank?
There's so many fucking hoaxes going on.
I just hoaxed the shit out of you.
Is this you yelling at me?
Yeah.
Yeah, yelling, fuck you, man. Looking at your face.
Dude, you should see your face.
Your face. You got that. You got fuck you to face.
I mean, I get it. It's pretty funny. I get it.
Oh, man.
Like, he's acting like he didn't hear you saying that he was going to do a prank because he had his headphones on. He was covering his ears over his hands over his headphones.
Nah.
Wait, hold on a second. You got the prank?
What's that?
You got the prank.
I got it, yeah.
Are you sure?
I get it, yeah. You said, fuck you, Randy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That
was okay, right?
And it was because of the thing that I stole from Brendan. He's pranking me because I stole that thing from him.
Wait.
You stole that thing from him?
Wait, what did you steal? No. I was pranking you just to prank you.
Oh, wasn't in retaliation?
No, it's not retaliation.
No. What'd you take from him?
I stole your video camera.
You what?
I stole your video camera.
The one that he keeps in his...
Why?
As a prank.
Were you going to give it back?
Well, if you want a smashed up video camera, yeah.
Why was it smashed up? Wait a minute. Was there anything on the tape? On the
I didn't know. I don't know how to use those things. Okay, I just put it on the sidewalk and stomped on it.
Randy, that's not a good prank.
So you took it out of my apartment?
Yeah. I took it down the sidewalk and I stomped on it.
Randy, that's not a good prank.
It was all into pieces.
It's kind of funny.
Yeah. And I was like, fuck you, Randy!
I know, that is a good prank.
I get it.
You get it?
That's so good.
That's pretty good.
Oh, man.
So did... yesterday was Labor Day.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Hopefully, this podcast will be released by Memorial Day, which marks the beginning of the summer.
Yeah.
What did you guys do? Did you do surfing? Well, Randy's a big surfer as well.
Yeah.
Did you catch some waves?
Yeah, I went on a surfing safari.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I went on a surfing safari. It was also my birthday. So I was like, birthday surfing safari, can't beat that.
Birthday surf.
Birth and surf.
Birthday surf. Yeah, birthday. I took the birthday limo down to the surfing safari, and I took a safari.
That was
surfing.
The best initiative we ever passed for the city, is that everyone gets a birthday limo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
really nice.
Move to Los Angeles.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
Get a birthday limo.
There's so many limos in Los Angeles.
There's a surplus of them because they need to have newer limos for celebrities and stuff like that. So you get like a slightly used older limo that takes you
But
around.
Every limo company has to have a birthday limo available. Yeah. It's like... And it's kind of like when doctors are on call. It's like, well, this is my week. I'm on call.
Yeah.
I have to do this. It's part of what I signed up for. So limo companies in Los Angeles are like that. So they're like, all right, one time a year, we have to do birthday limos for free.
Yeah. And because of this also, the benefit to
Well, it's not one time a year. Yeah.
But, I mean, like each company. Like, so, like, this company would be like, all right, this is our week, and then they don't have to worry about it. It's like when you're in the National Guard, you know.
Mm-hmm. And the big benefit for that is that all limo companies never have to serve on jury duty. Like, that's the give and take of the whole thing.
Yeah, there is a lot of paperwork.
Well, you wouldn't want a limo driver on your jury anyway.
No, they've...
They're all fucking cokeheads.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm confident in saying that. I don't even think that's, like, a weird sweeping generalization.
It's not slander at all, yeah.
Every single limo driver is a cokehead.
Yeah. That's probably true.
No, it is. It's a fact.
You know, you remember my old boss that you prank called that one time?
Oh, yeah.
One of his really good friends is a limo driver. and they're cokeheads.
Yeah. So. Yeah. That's why limos are long and sometimes white. Like, it looks like
a
line of coke.
Yeah, that's why they made them white.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
So if you're a limo out there listening, keep up the good work.
Yeah,
and
thanks for doing it.
I don't mind that you're on coke.
You don't mind?
I don't care. Do whatever you want, limo drivers.
Keeps them up. Makes them a more aware, aggressive driver.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of mirrors in limos, too.
Mm-hmm.
I like cokeheads. I mean, I don't do coke, but I like hanging out with cokeheads.
Yeah.
They're fun.
Really fun.
Yeah, they're cool.
They're creative.
They're very creative. They're very energetic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're always up for doing something.
Yeah. They don't care about tomorrow.
They're kind of living the moment, like old BW over here.
Best people to go see a movie with.
Yeah. You can go to see like a double feature with some cokeheads.
Yeah. Do you guys ever, have you ever gone to a movie and then snuck into a second one without paying? Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
All the time?
Yeah.
I haven't done it in a while because the movies I go to the Vista mostly.
Yeah. I can't go there anymore.
Oh, that's right.
You tried to see a double feature there.
Yeah.
You tried to sneak into the next one, but it was the same one, and they caught you.
It was like 30 minutes between the movies. So I'm just hanging around.
It's a one screen house, we should say.
It's a one screen house.
Yeah.
Like the house I grew up in.
And they have like these Egyptian guys on the sides.
Well, it's all run by cokeheads.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
everybody works there.
Everybody. Excellent.
Yeah, I don't think
drivers.
Anybody could sue me for saying that.
Really?
I mean, it's pretty. I think it's. They've done news articles and stuff.
Really? Mm-hmm. There's only like four people that work there.
Yeah, they're all cokeheads.
They're all cokeheads.
That's why they're constantly struggling with money at that theater.
But it just takes one and then they start hiring all their friends, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
That makes sense.
But like I said, I like cokeheads.
It's great.
I don't like coke, but I like cokeheads. I like hanging out with people who are on cocaine.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah. Terrible drug, but wonderful people.
Terrible drug.
Terrible drug.
It's a terrible drug.
Huh.
It's a terrible drug.
Terrible drug.
It's terrible.
Terrible drug.
Terrible drug.
It's a terrible drug.
Terrible drug.
It's horrible.
Drug's terrible.
It's a terrible drug.
Terrible drug.
Coke is dirt. It's terrible. It's a terrible, terrible drug.
It's a terrible.
It's terrible.
Why is it so terrible?
It's terrible.
But if it makes good people, it's still terrible.
It's a terrible drug, but
terrible
I don't
drug.
Mind the people who do it aren't terrible.
They're not terrible people for doing
terrible,
a terrible drug.
It's a terrible drug. That's why I wouldn't do it.
They're making a terrible decision.
It's terrible for you.
Yeah.
But I like cokeheads, man. They're pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pretty cool. Can I give away the best theater to sneak into another movie
in
Los Angeles? Is the AMC in Burbank.
Yeah.
AMC in Burbank is the easiest theater to sneak from film to film in.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I did it one Christmas season. I snuck into three films.
The whole season?
Yep. Well, no. The one day in the season.
Oh.
So you watch three movies in a day?
Three movies in a day.
What movies?
I've done that.
Oh, man. I've
I know Walk
that.
Hard was one. National Treasure 2. Book of Shadows was another. And then I forget the other one.
I would have just given up after the Book of Treasures movie.
The only time I ever did that was we went to a movie and it was really bad.
Uh-huh.
And so we walked out and went to a different one.
Was it better?
I don't even remember.
You know, that's funny. I saw Walk Hard.
Yeah.
In... Over Christmas, I guess, how many years ago? 3 years ago
Three
or something?
Four, yeah.
I did it the same way. And I also, another movie, I think I did three fucking movies too.
Really?
But I left on the last one.
Yeah.
Resident Evil was one of them.
Okay.
And Walk Hard. And there was another comedy. You know what I think it was? It was that Ben Stiller comedy, Heartbreak Kid, maybe?
Maybe, yeah.
I don't know, but that's crazy, because I think I did three movies that day, too.
Well, at the AMC? Oh, wait,
actually, at an AMC in Philadelphia.
Guys, AMC, best theater to sneak around in. Best theater chain, yeah.
Well, you know, everybody's too busy doing coke in the back to even check.
They're all cokeheads there, too?
Everybody
Come on,
AMC,
Randy, grow up, dude.
Yeah.
I am. I'm grown. But really, do you think all movie theaters?
I don't know about all. I wouldn't say the Newart.
New
Art Theater in Santa Monica. No, nobody there.
Nobody?
No. It's run by Recovering Cokehead.
Yeah.
It's
all really?
Recovering Cokeheads.
So they probably do drug tests.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you ever go to the Pooh Fart Theater?
Oh,
man, give it up.
Where's
give it
that?
Up for Brendan.
Cool. Where's that at?
It's right next to the New Art, the Pooh Fart.
Yeah, the Pooh Fart
Theater.
Oh, yeah, I get it.
All the movies they show there are fucking shit, though.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Oh, best high five.
Yeah, that's a good high five.
I get it.
You high five Randy if you want.
There we go.
Shit movies, man.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, it's good. It's like that. Yeah. Woo!
Good one, guys. I mean, us. Good one, us.
Yeah.
We should do... you think we should have random drug tests on the Bone Zone?
Okay.
Right now? Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it right now.
No.
That wouldn't be so random.
We gotta do
dissenter there.
Do you want? But I just think maybe we should like
we should test out drugs, right?
No.
What we should do: random drug.
What do you
tests.
Think? Do you think it should be a rule: no drugs in the Bone Zone because or no performance enhancing drugs in the Bone Zone?
Well, I don't think there should be performance enhancing drugs.
No,
you don't think so?
Not, yeah,
they're not.
Like, what if I'm like super funny one week?
Well,
and
that's
everyone's
why.
Like, what's up?
Yeah.
Yeah, we want people to see. How our performance, the ebbs and flows of our performances.
Uh-huh.
Like when we're really on, it's genuine. And when we're really off, it's because there's something real going on.
It's not
because
you're
maybe we had a terrible Labor Day.
Blood,
I don't know.
Blood doping or whatever those bicyclists do. What do? They take their blood out and put it back in?
I don't know.
Do something like that. I do that with
my
pee.
They take it all out at once and then put it all back in?
I pee dope. I take my pee out.
Mm-hmm.
Normal style.
Yeah, yeah, you pee.
And then I drink a bunch of water, get more electrolytes, and then I put the pee back. So then I have twice as much pee.
How do you put the pee back?
Same way it came in, out.
In the pee hole? You pee it in?
Uh-huh.
So you get a funnel?
No, it's more of like a foot pump that you would pump like an air mattress up with.
Oh, okay.
So it's got like a little nozzle hose and then one of those things that you step on.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And that squirts
it back up in there.
Oh, yeah. It hurts.
And then what happens, though? Then you just have to pee again, right?
Twice as much, though.
Oh.
Pretty cool, right?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Stretching out my bladder nice and big, too.
You're getting ready for the marathon.
Twice as much will really be like four times as much as like the month before.
Yeah.
So my bladder will be twice as big.
So you'll have a big advantage.
Oh, yeah. I'll be like, in the podcast, I won't have to pee for a long time.
Yeah. That'll come in handy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. What's the longest you ever went without peeing?
Probably 2 days.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Still, I have permanent damage from it.
That you really do, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That was just recently that happened?
A couple years ago
is when you went to, did the 2 day.
I don't know if it was 2 days, but I didn't hold it too long because I was scared to go out of my girlfriend's bedroom.
Because of monsters? You're afraid of monsters?
It was really dark in that hallway.
Yeah.
And I kept hearing a thing. And,
yeah.
And I saw that thing, a shadow.
What did it turn out to be?
Oh, it was just a cat. There's a cat and a ceiling fan.
Oh.
Freaking me
that's
out.
That's a scary combination.
Yeah.
Nothing scarier than a cat and a ceiling fan.
Yeah, but they were like a few hours apart. But.
This is kind of a mellow bone zone, huh?
Yeah.
It's kind of chill. I like it. All you weed heads out there.
All you weed heads.
This is the one for you.
Yeah.
Well, we should also mention that none of us are drinking alcohol right now.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Not.
Hmm.
Never thought of that.
I do have a big bag of alcohol over here, though.
Why aren't you drinking?
Should we have a drink?
Here's why I'm not drinking.
Mm-hmm.
I got off work. I ate 2 fried eggs and a pita bread.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. That sounds good. Mustard?
Mayo.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
That was pretty good.
Yeah.
And I was like, that way, by the time the bone zone starts, I will have already started digesting this food. I don't want to eat right before the bone zone.
Yeah.
Because it's like swimming. You have to kind of wait.
Yeah.
And then I was like, I had all this stuff that I had bought like last week. Food items, vegetables, proteins. Mm-hmm. I was like, I need to cook this before it starts to go bad. Because I'm probably not going to cook tomorrow night. So I spent 2 hours cooking wonderful food. But I wasn't hungry.
Oh.
And then by the end of it, I was like, well, I should eat some of it. Even though I wasn't hungry. So I ate a little bit of that. And then I also ate an ice cream bar.
Hmm.
How many ice cream bars?
One of the Häagen-Dazs ice cream bars?
Yeah, that you left in my freezer.
Ah. birthday ice cream bars for Randy.
I have to get Randy a birthday.
But I wasn't hungry, and then I ate chicken parmigiana in an ice cream bar right before I came here, and I was like, I guess I won't drink. And then I ate 3 cookies. And
you just had 3 cookies.
And a Subway soda.
And a giant soda. Yeah, I had a big, weird lunch. Just all Gelson's. I would buy like prepared food at Gelson's and their salad bar, which I realized today is just it's the least economic way to eat. Totally. Like the salad bar.
It's a ripoff, man.
It is fucking ripoff. Yeah. Like I never paid attention to it before. I think I got a bigger one today, you know, because I was like, I'll just fucking eat half of it.
Oh, man, it adds up so fast.
Dude, $16 salad.
It's all by weight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
$16 salad.
So you're paying the same for a carrot as you are for a big piece of chicken.
Yeah.
It was a pre-made salad? Like, it wasn't
No, it was one that I made. I just put a bunch of shit, but I bought the big one.
Ben. Okay.
And $16 for the salad, and then another $16 for the fucking, I get some, like, grilled vegetables and this like either way I kind of ate a lot and I ate soup and but like my stomach feels weird.
Oh man.
But I'll have a drink if you guys have a drink.
I'll have a drink.
I don't think I want to have a drink.
Yeah, I could do without it too.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I'm with you
guys. I got beer if you want a beer.
Oh, I'll have a beer if you guys have a beer.
I don't really want a beer.
Okay, I want
a beer. I would take a whiskey over a beer.
Yeah, I don't
really. Beer seems very filling.
I haven't had a beer in a long time. I'll have some whiskey, though.
You will? I'll have one if you have one.
You want a whiskey, Brendan?
Yeah. I'll do it if you do it.
All right, here.
Well, I don't know.
I mean, you have that nice new ice bucket and tongs and everything.
I did bring some nice ice. Oh, let's just have some ice.
Yeah,
oh, we could just have a glass of ice.
Glass of ice? Yeah.
I've been drinking. I was in Portland all weekend. I love Portland. I drank a lot of beer there.
A lot of beer. They have good beer there.
Yeah.
No, well, they have hipster beer, but they also have more breweries than Munich, Germany.
Yeah, they have more breweries, more microbreweries.
Don't you mean Munich? Munchie.
Can we find a Munchie theme song?
I don't know what Munchie is.
It's an old, it's like a stuffed animal for kids. It came out like
it's like a human face.
It's the one that had the sucky thumb thing.
It was weird, man. Remember that's right. It had a thumb sucker thing.
Didn't it have a banana too it could suck on?
Munchie, oh, so soft and cuddly.
It's called Munchie.
Munchie is like monkey.
We live up in the trees.
Kind of like a monkey thing. Oh, yeah, was there a cartoon of it too?
Yeah, Munchie.
It was a doll first.
Yeah.
Here you go, sir.
All right.
Glass of ice.
Three glasses of ice.
Yeah. Ready to party.
It's a waiting game.
Kind of like when you're surfing. That's a waiting game to get out there to the waves. Right?
Yeah. I did. Yeah. When I was on my surfing safari, it was a lot of waiting.
Yeah.
A lot of waiting for waiting.
I found it. It's so ridiculous.
Let's listen to this song. Oh, I meant the TV commercial. No, this isn't it.
They love to laugh and play, have a happy, happy day.
Do look for the TV
and
commercial.
Then the TV commercial. Whoops. Went on. Let's see. TV commercial. Here's a TV commercial.
Yeah. It's Munchie, girl doll, boy doll. School time and football fan outfits are each sold separately.
Munchie, Munchie, oh so soft and cuddly. With the thumb in her mouth, she's really neat. Fun to wiggle his little feet. Yeah, 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 yeah.
It's like a monkey.
Happy, happy Munchie.
I love you, Munchie.
I have no way of loving you back, little girl.
It must be like a Japanese thing or something. Yeah. Japanese are weird, man.
Oh, man, they can be weird stuff.
Do you remember Madballs?
Yeah. I liked Madballs. They're like foam balls that had scary faces on them.
Oh, you can put your, like, you can use them as puppets, kind of remove their.
No. They were just balls.
No, they're
like
just sports creepy balls. Here's Madballs.
Mad balls, gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball, they're gross, funny, yucky, sick. There's eight, so you can take your pick. We throw, catch, it's fun. There's so much gross in every one. Freaky fun is what they're for. There's so much ugly, so much more. Gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball. We play with a mad ball. We play with a mad ball.
Yeah.
Those commercials are fucking crazy, man.
We play with mad balls, yo.
Mad balls.
Yeah.
I had those mad balls. That was like in the time of like Garbage Pail Kids and stuff.
When
like
it was like
gross things.
Yeah, guys like gross things. Girls don't like gross things.
Yeah,
but some girls
freak out your sister.
Go out of their way. They'd be like, I like Garbage Pail Kids.
The awesome.
Yeah. You're like, oh cool. You'll let me finger you probably.
Yeah. Yeah. Then she's like, I'm into girls too.
Yeah. I want to gross out them.
Do you guys want some whiskey?
All right.
Awesome. Yeah, if you'll have some.
Yeah. If you guys do it, I'll do it.
Really?
Yep.
I don't know.
JV doesn't want to.
Well, I mean, you guys were kind of on the fence before, and I don't want to lead you guys over the fence. Unless
I brought six bottles of whiskey.
Okay, I'll do it. I'll do it. If you need to get rid of some, I'll do it.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, Brendan put his cool glasses on.
Brendan, do
got
you
some
want...
shades.
Got some shades.
Do you want... I brought that bottle
got
of scotch that you got. Do you want some of that?
Whatever.
Ooh. I don't really like scotch that much.
Okay.
Ooh, I'd like some.
I bought Randy Scotch and doesn't like it.
I don't really like scotch that much.
Why don't you like it? It's the strength of it?
Strength?
Too intense
like
for him.
The intense taste of it?
Yeah, it's too intense for him.
Can I have some of that?
Yeah.
Other whiskeys are just as intense.
Yeah, whatever.
They're just different flavors because they're made with different things.
I mean, the intense flavor of it, like the kind of, it hits your...
I don't like how it tastes.
The most...
Rye has an intense taste, too. It's just a different taste than scotch.
The whiskey that was the most intense that I ever had was whiskey I drank when I was camping. Get it?
Do you get it, Randy? Randy, that was a good joke.
Yeah, I get it.
Explain why it's funny.
Oh, yeah.
The most intense whiskey...
He ever had.
That he ever had was when he was camping.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it was, where did you grow up? Philadelphia?
Yeah.
Because, and what state is that in?
Pennsylvania.
Yeah. Because when you're camping in Pennsylvania.
Okay.
It's cold and you have to have really intense whiskey.
If you don't get a joke, we'll explain it to you.
It doesn't.
You don't have to. Nobody thinks any less of you if you don't get a joke.
Yeah, Randy, I promise it doesn't. I don't think you're. I think you're really smart. And just because you don't get a joke doesn't mean that I'm going to think that you're stupid.
Yeah, doesn't make you stupid. It just makes you like naive.
Yeah. On a specific subject.
You're not stupid.
Did you ever when you?
You're not that stupid.
You're not that stupid.
Did you ever put any pencils in your veins? Yeah. In
what?
Pennsylvania.
What? That would probably. Okay, I see what you're trying to do.
You're trying to relate back to us with a joke about putting pencils in your vein, yeah. But why would you say yeah at the end of it? Did you want to do like an accent? You ever put any pencils in your vein, yeah?
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Hey, you ever put any? You ever put any pencils in your vein, yeah?
Yeah.
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 Hey, you want to go put a pencil in your vein, yeah? Yeah.
In Pennsylvania,
yeah.
Let's go to New York and put pencils in our vein, yeah?
Yeah.
Not in New York.
Yeah.
Oh.
Ah, I got this big plate of spaghetti. Why don't you put a pencil in your vein, yeah?
Yeah, get a spicy meatball and put a pencil in it in your vein, yeah?
Oh, no. I come from India. I put a pencil in my vein, yeah?
Hello, I am Russian. I put your pencil in your vein, yeah.
Yeah. I put a pencil in your vein, yeah. Ooh. I'm feeling it long. I'm feeling it deep in my veins. I want everybody said, hello. Together for and sending him my Pennsylvania love. I gotta finish this drink. I'll be right with you in a minute.
Pennsylvania blues.
Oh, because it was in, you were camping inside of tents.
Yeah! Oh, Randy!
What the fuck?
Come on! Yeah,
I get that.
Yeah, now you get it.
Oh, you're with us!
Yeah, finally.
I'm with you 100%, guys.
You've always been 100% behind
me. Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah.
No, I don't think I don't notice it, bro.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
No, thank you,
no,
too.
Thank you.
Thank you for real, though.
And you're welcome.
Thank you, and you're welcome, too.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Davey?
Yeah.
Same goes for you.
Thank you very much.
Ditto, Davey.
You're welcome.
And also ditto Not to be, be redundant, but I feel the exact same for you guys.
Yeah,
both
yeah.
at the same time.
Ditto, Davey.
Ditto.
Ditto, Davey.
Ditto, Davey. Ditto, Davey in the house.
Yes. Cheers, guys.
Cheers, guys.
So we're drinking. We decided to drink.
Yep.
I guess we're having a drink.
There we go.
We got a toast.
You're toasting?
Well, oh, boy. What are we going to toast? Oh.
Here's to taking this podcast out of first gear and putting it into second.
We put it in second gear. Second Happy birthday gear. To my main man, Ranman.
Oh, Ranman, wow. Main man birthday.
Happy birthday,
what
Randy.
An honor.
Birthday, boy. I'd sing. We could sing happy birthday, but that costs like $10,000.
Well, not if we make up a new residuals. Birthday song.
We can make up a new birthday song.
How about snappy birthday?
Snappy birthday.
Snappy birthday to
the Ranman.
To the Ranman.
I'm wishing snappy birthday to the Ranman. And many the snappy birthdays to follow.
Many have come before you, but this is your special day. It's a snappy day. Yeah.
Snappy birthday.
Snappy birthday to you, Randy Ranman.
Snappy birthday.
Another snap into this whiskey.
Yeah.
Oh, snap into the whiskey. For real, dude. 100%.
Yeah.
Right all the time, you. Right behind you.
Right yeah. back at you.
Ditto for you, Davey.
Ditto for you, Davey.
Same back to you guys.
Same back to you. Cheers. Cheers.
Right back. Cheers.
Well, another thing. Mm. Spit it back in there. You got to spit it back.
Okay.
A number one.
Yeah.
Fucking both you guys tied for first place in my book.
Oh shit. Right there. Both of you are tied for first place.
Yeah. Really?
First.
So it's a three-way first place tie?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. If you tally all the votes, it's a three-way first tie.
Hey. That means that instead of periods, we'd be having ellipses.
And eclipses, yeah.
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 Right behind 100%.
Three-way.
All right. Cheers.
Ditto, Davey. Yeah. Cheers.
There we go.
Whoa, wait. No, for real.
Back out.
Red Band. We forgot about Red Band.
Oh, Red Band.
Do you want a drink?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Do you got something?
Got a drink? He's getting a drink? Yeah. It'd be uncouth. It'd be unsportsmanlike.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Right.
Twister bottle.
Twister.
Cheers. Okay. 100%.
Right number one team. Here we go.
All
right,
guys.
Right back at you guys.
Cheers. Ditto, Davey.
Cheers. Ditto, Davey. Got it right out. Forgot.
Yeah.
Romney, 2012. Romney.
Oh, yeah.
Make sure Romney Ryan.
Romney Ryan. Best ticket out there.
Four-way tie. Yep. Five-way tie.
Yep, Romney. Five-way.
All right.
For the Fallen. Whoa, wait. For the Fallen. Forgot.
For the Fallen. Oh, gross.
Give a little one for the Fallen. Let's drink to the Fallen.
What's that mean?
All of our homies. All of our homies. Pass on.
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers.
I wish we could go back in time. I had one more thing.
Oh, you did?
It's too late, I think.
Oh, wait. Well, let's take the time machine.
Should we?
Yeah.
We haven't used it
in a long-ass time.
It's really expensive, though.
Well, I mean, we've been saving up for special occasions.
Well, if we're going to go back, how far back do you want to go?
If we're going to do it, we better do it quick because it's by the second.
We'll go back right before we did the Romney Ryan ticket test.
Right before that?
Right before that.
Okay.
Okay.
Here we go.
So, oh, dude. I forgot how uncomfortable this thing is. Oh, shit.
No, wait. Before we toast.
What's that?
Guys?
Yeah.
There's a dinosaur outside the window.
What?
What? We went back too far in time!
Let's go forward in time.
Okay.
I always have to poop when we get
this whiskey is not doing me good in this time machine. You'll be able to drink in the time machine. No, neither of you guys is wearing a watch, are you? Don't wear a watch in a time machine.
No.
Okay. Why?
I don't know. It fucks shit up.
Yeah.
Well, I just wanted to give one more toast.
Okay.
I don't even remember what it was for.
Oh, dude.
It must have been for, like, to the troops or something.
All right.
All right, to the troops.
The troops.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I mean, it sucks that we had to use a time machine.
Oh, yeah. That'll be... Mm-hmm. My MasterCard will be billed for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We split it three ways, so.
Freeway.
Yeah. And ellipses, right, guys? You get it.
Like a three-way.
Yeah.
Freeway?
Like the number three.
Freeway of love.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Like a pink Cadillac on the freeway of love, oh yeah.
You got
that guitar here? Maybe let's another song.
You got a soulful voice, Brendan.
It's from years of smoking.
You got a smoker's voice.
Smoking!
Yeah. Somebody's smoking. Ooh. That sounds like lavender.
Like lavender, huh? All right. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's my guitar really playing.
That's really fresh. Nice.
Yeah, you got
thanks.
You got the licks.
Whoa, that's a versatile guitar. Whoa.
You know, I gotta admit, I liked it more when you were acoustic. I might not like you electric. Okay, all right. I'm kind of getting into
this. Way of love in my pink Cadillac, oh boy. Freeway of love, riding in the fast lane in my pink Cadillac.
Whoa. You're good.
God, dude.
Freeway of pink Cadillac. Wow.
Yeah, dude, I'm just making this up. Riding in the fast lane in my pink Cadillac on the freeway of love.
I know he said he's making it up, but I think he's lived with it so long that it's been inside you.
Got the top down and drinking delicious wine with my baby.
It's a metaphor. It's a very good metaphor.
Nobody can stop me, and I'm doing the speed limit, but I'm speeding, yeah.
Means he doesn't wear a condom.
Speeding to you, baby.
Oh.
On the freeway of love in my pink Cadillac in the fast lane, drinking delicious wine.
Oh, man.
At the same time as driving?
Yeah.
Oh, man, when you're in love, you don't give a shit.
You really captured a lot there.
Thanks, man.
Dude, you're mad welcome, son.
You're mad powerful. You're
powerful, son.
Yeah. Well, you're mad, you know, mad respect, son. Yeah.
Mad respect to you, too.
All right, son. Ditto, Davy.
Ditto, Davy.
Mad
ditto
respect Davy. To you, son.
Yeah. Mad scientists.
Yeah, dog. Science.
We're all mad scientists.
Oh, your science is tight.
It's fucking science,
off
dog.
Off the chain. My chain's off the hook, but I'm still on the chain.
Oh, well, you know.
Oh, dude. Don't. Yeah, if your chain comes off the hook, though, you got to.
Get off the chain.
Well, you're going to have to get it repaired.
You can't leave the chain off the hook.
You have to make sure to keep it greased, otherwise
that type of thing can happen.
Yeah.
Yeah. Once the chain falls off, everything falls apart.
It's maintenance, you know. If you have a big thing and the chain goes off the hook, you know, then you're screwed for like a day. But if you spend the time to maintain it, your chain will never go off the hook. Mm-hmm.
Just get some WD-40.
Okay. Great idea. Yeah. I mean, they make specialty products, but you can just use like any standard lubricant, you know.
Okay, any lubricant.
Yeah. Basically,
well, you don't want to use like Vaseline or butter or something.
Oh yeah, probably not butter. But it's, I mean, whatever. Google it.
In a pinch.
Like a candle? Like
in a pinch, like if you were stranded somewhere. But just Google it.
If you guys were stranded on a desert island,
how
much butter would you bring with you?
Oh, my God.
Seven.
That's like the impossible question. Seven butter? Yeah.
Seven butter.
I'd bring seven butter.
You butter. I'd just bring a cow. You know what? I would I'd manufacture it.
He who learns how to if you teach him to fish, that's the same sort of thing.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
If you teach me how to fish, you'll have butter for life.
Have butter for life, yeah.
Butterfish.
Butterfish. Mm. Everything butterfish.
Oh. Yeah, I'll high five to that.
Okay. What would you... Randy.
What's up?
If you were stranded on a desert island,
okay.
What three things would you take with you?
Are they three things that I already have, or could I take anything?
You can take anything, but a boat or a plane. Like, you can't get off the island. There's just things that you have to have.
Okay, so they don't have to
pretty
be
pretty practical things.
They don't have to be things that I already have.
Mm-hmm.
Are you thinking personal items or, like, survival items? That's for me to decide.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right. Well, I would bring. I would bring. A whole.
Yeah, Brandon. I got Randy preoccupied.
I would bring a whole.
Yeah, he's thinking.
I'm gonna prank the fuck. I'd bring like a baguette, a whole baguette.
Do you want to prank him?
Like a loaf of bread. Can I say if I say like a whole bunch of baguettes, is that one thing?
Well, I think Randy, what you can
it can be a bag of baguettes.
Yeah, but if you are going to say something, I think it should be. Fuck what? You, Randy! Fuck you, Randy! Oh man!
Fucking pranked you!
Yeah,
double pranked!
Double pranked!
You should
both
see
sides.
Your face
you got
right
double
now.
Team, man.
you
should.
You guys don't even. You don't know how that makes me feel. You don't even care, do you, about what I was going
to do? No, I do care. I do care.
So you want me to keep going?
So you have a whole thing of baguettes.
Yeah.
Well, basically, I want the main thing I want to be able to do is have sandwiches. Mm. So if I say bread, meat, and cheese, is that my three things? Or can I say sandwich is, and that's one thing?
Hmm. No. Yeah, sandwich would be one item.
Okay, but can I say sandwiches? Can I say unlimited sandwiches? That's one thing.
Mm, I don't think that's, that's
like, what about like, can I bring a Subway, a restaurant? That one thing?
I guess. But well, then you're going to have a lot of stuff in there.
Yeah, you won't be getting
Then eventually you could say, I'd like to bring New York City. Is that one thing? Yeah, you're going to get up
there's
to
a lot
that
of
level.
Subways there.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I wouldn't have to. I could just go get like a world famous pastrami sandwich.
Well, I mean, if you bring New York City as one of your items, then pretty much you'll have whatever you need.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, I've never been to New York, so I don't know if I actually, if that does have what I need. So could I say, like, I could say Los Angeles.
Well, I guess.
Yeah. So we're going to bring?
Let's say.
Oh, it's a hard decision.
How about I will bring the West. Okay, I know. I'll bring the West Coast.
Okay.
And then I'll bring the East Coast for my second thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then some sandwiches.
Just
so
in
like
case,
a bag
just
of sandwiches.
Just in case they run out.
Yeah, in case LA doesn't have sandwiches.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I always.
You know, it's better be safe than sorry.
Just like to pack my own lunch.
Yeah, better be safe than sorry.
Butter
be safe.
Butter be safe.
Yeah. Well, it's a stick of butter with a condom on it. Butter be safe.
I should sell that.
Yeah.
But it's only in cold climates.
Yeah.
Oh, otherwise, you got it.
Erect in cold climates.
Otherwise, you got a latex condom full of clarified butter.
That's not too bad to have.
Yeah. I guess if you want.
There's been worse things that I've owned.
If you want,
you dip lobster in that shit.
Yeah.
If you want to prank someone.
If you want to prank someone, melt their condom butter.
Yeah. Classic.
Should we? I don't know. Should we call someone or something? What do you guys feel like doing?
Oh yeah, maybe we should.
I feel like we're having a lot of fun.
Yeah,
we are.
So we just
we're juiced up. We
turn it up
this.
To 11.
Yeah, let's turn it up to 11. Let's call or what's? Do you want to take calls? What do you think?
Should we take a call?
It always blows up in our face.
Yeah.
Should we? You guys feeling it?
I don't know. I feel a little deflated.
We could talk about Randy's erection he had earlier today.
What?
You guys know? You guys saw that?
What are you talking about?
When he came in here, he was having a huge erection.
You had a boner?
No, not. I mean, if it was a full boner, it wouldn't fit in my pants.
Whoa!
Whoa, jeez.
You hear that, ladies? And he's single!
Yeah. I'm not single.
And he's single, ladies.
I'm not single.
Just for the show.
Okay.
Randy's single and looking to mingle. Someone
single.
On the phone?
Yeah, if you want somebody on the phone? I don't know if it works. This is a new laptop. Let's see if it works.
I mean, I heard it ringing.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if they can hear us.
Okay, well, let's see.
Oh, we didn't give out the number.
The number?
I try it.
Hello?
Hey!
Somebody's on the phone.
Oh, who is this?
Oh, maybe they can't hear us.
I don't think they can hear us.
Uh-oh. All right.
That's good.
Yeah.
Well, you guys had your chance.
Yeah,
now
you blew
it's
it.
Over.
You
blew
have,
it.
You could have been the one person to call up and say, hey, but this person beat you to it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We could call those strippers on that.
Oh, yeah, the XM stripper line. Show. I was thinking about that today.
Do you think it's still happening?
Do they?
I mean, we did it. We did our show around the same time that time.
Yeah. Do you know if that stripper show is happening?
Is that too hard to figure out? Stripper podcast?
Let me see if I can fix this the phone real quick.
Right.
Okay. Technical difficulties.
No, little technical difficulty. Go, a little technical difficulty.
Partner, mess, we're fixing it up.
God bless this mess and pardon our technical difficulties.
Have you ever been stranded on an island? Has anybody ever been stranded on an island?
Ever in real life?
Tom Cruise from that Castaway movie.
Oh, yeah, I heard that. After they shot that film, he was stranded on an island.
They left him
while.
Behind.
Yeah.
He went off to go use the restroom, and the boat left. Mm-hmm. When he came back, he was like, for real, you guys?
One time I got stuck between two rocks.
Well, but no hard
for
place.
Real?
Mm-hmm.
How'd you get out?
I just eventually got out.
Oh.
My foot was stuck. I was in a river, and my foot was stuck between two big rocks.
How old were you?
I was like 9.
Were you afraid you're going to drown? Was it that?
I wasn't afraid I was going to drown. I was afraid I wasn't going to have a ride home. Because my mom thought I was with my dad, and my dad thought I was with my mom. Classic bad parenting.
Yeah.
And I knew that they were both walking like back to leave. And once they got to their cars, they were going to drive like 30 miles away.
And then they would realize, oh, we left our stupid son.
Yeah, stuck between two rocks where we stuck him.
Yeah. Mm. Oh, they stuck you there?
Oh, yeah. They lifted up one rock and so I wouldn't paddle away.
Yeah, yeah.
But I was like, help! I was doing classic, like, help.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And finally, when I got out, there's people, like, on the other side of these rocks that never came to help me.
Oh, no shit. They were just sitting there?
I was stuck for, like, 30 minutes.
That long?
Yeah, and then I had once I got out, I had to run as fast as I could to catch up with my dad, who would just get into his truck to leave.
How were you stuck in there?
I was trying to climb. There's these two big boulders in the river, and I was trying to climb out between the two of them, but then I fell, and my foot got wedged between the two because they eventually met. So there was a crack that went down, and then my foot was stuck. So I was like stuck between these two rocks. And then I feel like they were trying to, that was like the day that they were trying to get rid of me, you know?
Mm.
Oh, Joe Dirt style?
Yeah, because I followed this trail of like chips.
Yeah?
Yeah.
To that area.
Potato chips?
Poker
like,
chips.
Like, yeah, like Lay's barbecue potato chips.
Oh, your favorite.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're delicious. And I was following this trail of chips and I was like, huh, another one. Yeah. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Another one. Until I was in this area that's like, you know, you're not supposed to be walking.
Yeah.
And I was stuck between these two rocks.
And you're still eating chips off the ground there?
Hey, can you hear us on the phone?
Somebody on the phone?
I can.
Hello?
Hello, this is Randy's grandmother.
Oh, hi, Grandma.
Hi, Randy. Happy birthday.
Oh, thanks. That's sweet.
Davey, I'll talk to my grandma. Oh. Thank you.
Can I just say, Randy's a good grandson.
Who is that?
This is Davey. Randy talks highly of you.
I like you. Put my Randy back
I'll
on.
Shut up now. Randy, you talk to
Hey, Grandma.
Hi, Randy. Yo, you put that man back on the phone. Are you okay?
I'm okay, yeah, but you called yesterday, Grandma.
Yeah, happy birthday. I just love you so much, little Ram man.
Well, I love you too, Grandma. Did you write my number down? You remember my number?
I got your number.
I know that you said you were going to buy me a savings bond for my birthday.
Huh?
A savings bond.
Did you get the cream I sent you for your little dickie?
To Grandma, that's
you gotta rub that cream on your little dicky.
That's the stuff.
You got that rash is gonna get. It's gonna get bigger, and you gotta rub the cream on your dicky.
Grandma, I know that you were a nurse, but that was like
I rub
70
it on it
years
for you.
Ago.
If I was there, I would rub it on you.
I know
for
you would, Grandma, but I don't need that cream. That cream, it's been proven that cream doesn't work.
Who is this? Is this that man again?
No. This is Randy, Grandma.
No, it's Randy. You're talking to Randy.
Who
right
is this?
Now.
Who? No. Randy, I'm scared.
Don't be scared, Grandma.
Randy, I'm scared.
It's because you're cold. Turn up the heat.
I can't. The man was the guy who was going to come fix my dryer, and the dryer's not fixed. I haven't been in the
You haven't drawn.
I haven't been in the dryer for a week.
Really?
Yeah.
You're probably soaking wet, Grandma.
I'm soaking wet. I'm all wrinkled.
I will call Mom, and I will have her put you back in the dryer, okay?
Okay, thanks, honey.
All right.
Happy birthday.
All right, thanks
for
that.
You put that cream on your dick, okay? You do that for grandma.
I'll put it on. I'll send you a picture.
You send me pictures of your little dickie.
Okay, grandma.
Okay, I love you.
Okay, I love you too, grandma.
Bye, Randy.
Bye.
Man, what a sweet old woman your
grandma is.
Oh, my God.
She's still on the
grandma
phone.
Grandma Lidke, you still on the phone?
Well, I don't know what to... Who is this?
This is Davey. This is Randy's friend, Davey.
Do you know how to fix the dryers?
No, I'm not the dryer guy.
You got the cream for your dickies?
I don't have cream for my dickies.
Okay, thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Huh?
Hey.
Who's this?
Brendan Walsh.
Who is this?
This is Brendan Walsh.
This you got a little dicky.
My grandma called yesterday too, but she accidentally called. Apparently, she called my parents' house and left a message for me there. She got the numbers mixed up. My grandma is very old.
How old is she?
Good setup.
How old is she? Yeah. Well, she's 93.
Ugh, that's not a good joke.
That's not how the joke should go. Oh. She'd be like,
she's here. So old!
Yeah, there you go.
She is so old!
Uh-huh.
She's 93.
No, but that's... Oh, okay, Davey.
Factual.
Davey?
I was going to say Davey set it up again. Yeah.
My grandma is so old!
How old is she?
She is so old that... When she cooks breakfast, she's like, what are these tiny eggs? These ain't dinosaur eggs.
All right.
My grandma is so old.
How old is she,
dog? She is so old that she's like, what kind of eggs are these? Are these chicken eggs? I'm used to dinosaur eggs.
Yeah, all right. You're in it.
So old.
How old is she?
She's so old that she's like, she was she signed the Declaration of Independence.
Yeah, man.
How old is she? My grandma's so old that she... She's cooking dinner. And she's like, what do you want for dinner? And I was like, T-bone steak. And she was like, how about a dinosaur steak?
My grandma is so old.
How old is she?
She's so old
that she's like, she was on the Mayflower?
The Mayflower!